The following is a presentation of TFNN. The Power Trading Hour with your host, David White. Call now, toll free at 1-877-927-6648. Internationally at 727-445-1044. Now, David White.
And welcome all to another exciting edition of the Power Trading Hour. And it doesn't matter whether you're on the 19th hole or on the South Pole, we love it when you come at this time.
The following takes place between 2 p.m. and 3 p.m.
And, well, we don't have much going on. We're just kind of stuck around this 3950 area on the S&P cash over the last few days. And down, let's update this just to make sure. We're down, let's call it 16 points at this point, 3955 on the S&P 500. Dow's down 90, NASDAQ's off 50, Russell up 25, kind of the best one, crude off a buck. The big disappointment, kind of loser of the day, is gold. That ugly yellow metal, or the most precious thing on the planet, depending on what planet you are on. Really started to move on comments last night, along with the TLT and the bonds. On comments that they were going to do whatever it takes to pass some rather large spending bills in the Senate, basically saying they're going to get rid of the filibuster. So you won't need 60 votes. All you'll need is 50 and the vice president. And I continue to look at the bond market as a kind of a preemptive bond vigilante market. They see this coming down the road, and why it took a little time for them to wake up to it in the 90s, they're being extremely proactive. CLT is actually up 47. It was in the high 134s pre-market, I don't know, 6 or 7 a.m. in the morning. Now, of course, we've got a shortened week. And instead of starting to let the cash come into the market and trying to support the bond market on Thursdays, I think what we're starting to see is everybody anticipate that cash come into tomorrow, since we won't be here. We're Amscray Attenlay on Friday, for those into Pig Latin. But, you know, the big pushes like yesterday, day before, volume has not increased. And really, if you are bearish, the most bearish thing would be low volume pushes all the way into Friday or into Thursday's close. Most people, though, would think, well, I got to make some money today, and may just be giving off a little bit of money. I don't think there's that much to the upside, but might be giving just a little away. I would say that you continue to want to stay away from the most highly shorted stocks, although even today they are not doing much. We'll talk about them later. And you know what? Can you kind of hang out here in the TLT? I think you can. But there's a lot of cash being thrown at this market just to keep that thing around where it is now. And in that, I mean the bonds. So we shall see. But, you know, never ending. This isn't a thing to turn around the market from the lows. This is a thing to plug as many holes in the dike as you can. Whenever they go after and try to push the TLT, start seeing the gold go lower. You see the S&P start to have a bad time, and even the NASDAQ. And of course, the advanced decline line continues to be just horrific. If you didn't pay attention to it yesterday, let me pop this up here. Where's that at? There it is. Short sales, put call ratio, advanced decline. Okay. I put this in my newsletter every day, but you know, what we're seeing is declining issues, 3,200 to 1,000 in the NASDAQ. Not quite as bad in the New York Stock Exchange, 2,200 to 1,100. But it just isn't a good-looking market when most of the stocks are down, yet they continue to push very hard on the markets. And, of course, can they do this all the way into Thursday? I would hope so. In fact, I would love to see them push this up on no volume to maybe 4,000 on Friday, on Thursday's close. Come back Monday, maybe see a little bit of buying from fund managers who didn't buy on Thursday, just decided to put it off until Monday. Maybe see a little bit of bounce and then a big failure come Monday or Tuesday. You know, the market is not strong, so it could fail at any time. But if I'm trying to make an ideal case for shorting the market, I think it would be either the close on Thursday, and then you have the 3 days, or I think that they come back and try to buy on Monday, push the market up a little bit, and then it fails once again. Now, the best thing would be, if you're bullish, is the market to go lower on a lighter volume. And of course, being Tuesday, we only have two more days this week. Volume will start to decrease tomorrow, probably by one-ish, maybe even earlier than that. A lot of the people, of course, on Wall Street will be headed out to open their homes out in on Long Island, out there on, what is that? Not Westchester. The Hamptons, what I'm thinking about. Okay. everybody's having fun in the dead. Just do that. Anyway, not expecting a whole lot. Am thinking that the market gets pushed up a little bit higher, and maybe that's what sets what we are looking for off. Now, I could be wrong. I am neither long nor short. I am waiting for a fairly decent signal. And that signal could be a nice pop and instant failure, as we talked about in the silver market yesterday, where you have that pretty significant blow off. You know, that's not a signal that you can really read a lot of different ways. And maybe we get something exactly like that. But market doesn't look good. Got a lot of pushing on few stocks. Got a stock that is I think, giving us fairly decent signal today that spells trouble for most of the smartphone manufacturers. Did post some articles earlier in the day in the Den talking about semiconductors, who all think that at least there is another quarter of big problems in supply in the semiconductor business. So we'll keep an eye on that. A lot of people, I think, whistling past the graveyard. But we shall see. When we return, we'll do a little bit of history. And then we go into what I see. A lot of stocks that kind of weak for what we should be seeing in some squeezes as volume goes lighter. Not happening much. We'll be back in a minute.
Are you grinding in the market but seeing little to no return? Or are you a successful trader simply looking to make his job a little easier? Learn to take the path of least resistance with David White's powerful trading newsletter. David White is an accomplished trader whose deep understanding of technology and the markets allows him to consistently find and share winning trades. Support and resistance define the ranges in which stocks trade. By understanding these trading ranges, David White is able to find the path of least resistance. David White's trading newsletter, The Path of Least Resistance, is delivered daily before the markets open to make every trading day an easy win. Visit TFNN.com today and subscribe to David White's Ultimate Trading Newsletter for $119 a month, and try all of our newsletters risk-free with our 30-day money-back guarantee. Take the path of least resistance at TFNN, educating investors.
Thank you. If you're not currently using the TAS profile scanner when looking at setting up your trading opportunities, then your arsenal is short a mighty weapon. The TAS Profile Scanner is a standalone piece of software that instantly filters over 2,500 global financial markets such as stocks, ETFs, commodity futures, and Forex. Headed by Steve Dahl, TAS understands that in today's technological world, the use of top-flight software applications and technical analysis expertise is essential to successful trading in today's market. You also gain access to the webinar that Steve Dahl and Tom O'Brien just hosted, The Best Way to Use the TAS Profile Scanner to Profit. This webinar archive is available for all subscribers immediately upon signing up. All new subscriptions also come with a 30-day money-back guarantee, so you have nothing to risk. Start your subscription by visiting the front page of TFNN.com today, and you'll find the TAS Profile Scanner under the Services tab. Sign up today.
Hey there, I'm Andy Arbertine with Tiger Precious Metals and Stones. Whether you're looking to buy and sell precious metals or trying to find the perfect diamond ring, I'm here to help. I have over 15 years of experience with diamonds and precious metals. You can call me directly at 727-329-8245, and I will personally answer any questions you have and help you find exactly what you're looking for. I will be your personal concierge in the metal and stone business. Give me a call today, 727-329-8245.
Many of our new listeners have heard about The Tiger's Den. The Tiger's Den is a lively community where professional traders and investors can meet, exchange ideas and information in a comfortable, moderated atmosphere. Hear all of the TFNN shows, plus see all of the charts as they happen live and have access to archives of all of those charts. You can test drive The Tiger's Den absolutely free for 30 days and greatly enrich your knowledge of these markets and how to make your money work for you. Details on The Tiger's Den are on the front page of TFNN.com. Call now, toll free at 1-877-927-6648. Internationally at 727-873-7618.
And it's all just a little bit of history repeating.
Well, I got a digit off on this one. It should be 1867. On this day, the U.S. Secretary of State William Seward signs a treaty with Russia for the purchase of Alaska for $7 million, despite the bargain price of roughly 2 cents an acre. I'll take that. I think I got 2 cents. The Alaska purchase was ridiculed by Congress and morons, and the press as Seward's folly. Press was much like it is today. A lot of fake news. Can't see past the end of their nose. Anyway, they called it Seward's Follies, Seward's Icebox, and President Andrew Johnson's Polar Bear Garden. Of course, it wasn't more than 30 years, they pulled out 10 times more than the purchase price in gold in the last few years of the 1800s. Or is that the 1900s? I always get that mixed up, the way they count that. But in 1900s? I would say the 1800s because it starts with an 18, but I think that's the 1900s because they think that it kind of rolls into the next year. Never really understood it. Seward, of course, undershadowed for the assassination attempt for President Lincoln. He was the guy's name was Powell, which always makes me think of the Fed president. Anyway, a disgruntled Southerner, Powell, decided to go and kill Seward the same night that they went after Lincoln and did eventually kill him. This guy named Powell ran around and stabbed Seward. Didn't get very far because he had some kind of accident and had splints and all kinds of stuff all over him. Anyway, the guy ran around his house, stabbed everybody, his daughters, his other folks. When we talk about real insurrections and not fake insurrections, this was, again, a real attempt to overthrow the government of the United States. You know what? He did live long enough to see that this was a great idea. You know what? They're not making any more land these days. And on a long enough time scale, probably always a good deal in 1867. Okay, what else is going on here? We wanted to get some charts. I wanted to talk about probably the most important chart that I'm looking at today. And this is Avago Technologies. Again, we're probably not going to have a lot of volume, but I think in the next couple of days, it's going to be very tough to see Apple or the rest of these companies. Let's take a look at Skyworks Solution, SWKS. not much happening in that, but of course, Apple is getting ready for its third week in a row to go into Friday at $120. From looking at, it could do that all over again. So not expecting a great deal of movement in the markets since Apple basically negates 12% of the NASDAQ if it's not going anywhere. Some of the other stocks, but again, a variety of issues, but Avago mostly on the problem with getting enough silicon chips out into the market, kind of putting the same thing on Apple. It's down a lot, doesn't have a lot of volume, but certainly nothing that's going to be solved in the next or the second quarter of the year. We're going to be going into late summer before this really turns around. Of course, Apple has announced its big to-do, which is somewhere around June. From rumors, we're finding out that really the next big iPhone with some neat features that maybe people want to buy, they're going to talk about that in that July-June developers conference, and the product's going to ship somewhere in September or October. So I don't suspect that we're going to see a lot from Apple. They're pretty good at keeping things secret. And on the opposite side of it, some of the surveys over the last few days of what people are spending the latest COVID stimulus checks on is the bank. I went to Best Buy on Saturday. It was busy, but it wasn't busy as it was last summer with highly expensive products. These people were buying a lot of small things as I stood in line. I had to get a new cell phone because I mistakenly dropped mine in some water. And it had been sealed fairly good, but I had to replace the screen because I cracked it. And, of course, no more waterproofing for that. And I ended up with a new phone. Anyway, while I was standing around there buying one, got to watch everybody. And it's always a good thing when you're out and about to see what people are doing, what they're buying. It may be somewhat anecdotal, but it may give you an idea for further research. But talk to the gal behind the counter as I was buying my new cell phone and asked her what was going on. She said, just people buying a lot of little stuff. They're not really buying the big stuff the last couple of weeks. Maybe that will change as more people get their checks. But a lot of people, the banks have been surveyed, and a lot of people took their checks and they put them in the bank. They are not going back to going wild on buying television and new cell phones so far in the first week. The Turlet, what's the difference between a tattoo, an event, or a conference? A to-do? Okay. What goes on in Apple's to-do or conference is their developer conference. And that's June or July. Forget when it was. But at that point, they reveal the new features. So when the product launches, maybe somebody will have some software for it. So it is kind of a chicken and the egg thing. But they'll show off the new features on kind of a high level. And then for the people they really want to develop stuff for, they'll make them sign non-disclosure agreements and stuff like that. And they'll get the real skinny on how to develop maybe something new, like heartbeat sensors. I know they're working on a lot of stuff that applies to health. That seems to be the biggest part. New screens, better screen displays, some other stuff like that. Somebody in the den says that they're buying used cars, which may be. Maybe that's why you put it in the bank so you can write a check. not just grab the cash and run up to Best Buy and get a new cell phone. Just a thought. Anyway, volume's been decreasing for a handful of days. It is fairly light so far today. Let me just make sure that I got it here. Got some questions to answer when we come back already, but volume pretty pathetic at about 6.8 billion shares. So I'm pretty sure that we're already seeing the people that are the masters of the universe on Wall Street probably already headed out to the Hamptons. But I'll have a better forecast when I talk to my nephew, who's up there watching those folks. He's out there and can watch them go right by where he works out on Long Island. We'll be back in a minute.
Hi folks, this is Tom O'Brien. The printing presses are working 24 hours a day, 7 days a week. The U.S. deficit has risen 200% in 1 year with no end in sight. The markets are looking for an additional stimulus bill to get us through this once-in-a-generation pandemic. There is no free lunch, folks. The more stimulus dollars put into the marketplace, the less your dollar is worth each and every day. This is the time to protect yourself with a portion of your portfolio in the metal market. The Gold Report comes out each Monday morning. I bisect and dissect the dollar, silver, gold, the XAU, and the HUI. The Gold Report is a long-term hedge against the dilution of your buying power. The U.S. has put more than $6 trillion into the marketplace in the last 6 months, with more expected in the next few months. The market did and does need the stimulus, but it will have long-term implications on our buying power. The Gold Report comes with a 30-day money-back guarantee. Go to TFNN.com and order the Gold Report now. Protect your buying power. Order the Gold Report now.
You could be making money off the stock market. And if you're already making money off the stock market, you could be making a lot more. Check out TFNN and Tiger TV and get expert investing advice to give you the power to control your financial future. Go to TFNN.com and find the newsletter for you. Whether you're into trading gold, metals, futures, currencies, or options, you'll get advice and analysis to help you seriously get ahead. TFNN also features trading services with a 30-day money-back guarantee for new subscribers, as well as TFNN's Tiger Den Trading Room, trading software, and educational webinars for all trading levels. And make sure you check out Tiger TV for free on TFNN.com or TFNN's YouTube channel for live financial content from 8:30 a.m. to 4 p.m. Eastern on market days. Stop watching on the sidelines while other people get rich and become the investor you were born to be. TFNN, educating investors.
TFNN is excited about our new software charting program, The Art of Timing the Trade Charts. In collaboration with Tom O'Brien and using his best-selling book, The Art of Timing the Trade, Your Ultimate Trading Mastery System, David White has programmed an outstanding piece of software that will complement any trader's methodology. Using this first-of-its-kind program, The Art of Timing the Trade Charts allows you to scan thousands of stocks for Fibonacci formation setups, including Gartley's, ABC's, Butterflies, and much more. The Art of Timing the Trade Charts is designed to help you when scouring the markets for stocks just beginning to form the trading patterns that many investors spend days, weeks, or even months searching to find. And right now, we're offering licenses available at only $79 a month. We are so confident that you're going to love this new charting software that will even give you a 30-day unconditional money-back guarantee. Don't miss out on this incredible new piece of software. Get your copy of The Art of Timing the Trade Charts today by visiting TFNN.com.
This segment is brought to you by Think or Swim. For more information, just click the Think or Swim banner on the front page of TFNN.com.
And someone mentioned dire straits. Can't think of a better line in a song in the 80s than that. Prehistoric garbage trucks have the cities to themselves. If you've ever been out late night in New York, made a lot of sense to me anyway. We're talking about Apple coming back down. There was some questions, so I want to get to that. And yeah, I've got a lot of emails that are along the similar lines, so I'm going to make a comment that delves into the political. And that is that, yeah, everybody's a hypocrite to some level or another. And yeah, I've seen it all. You got Mr. Bezos yelling and screaming that no one should have a driver's license or any form of ID to vote in the elections. But of course, he's demanding it now that they want to unionize. In fact, that's going on today. I should have brought that out. And of course, looks like it's going to pass. And of course, he's using his newspaper to hammer on the anti-unionization front. I don't know if it's going to be good or bad for the people that actually work there long term, but kind of interesting that the guy that tends to always say one thing does another. And yeah, I know it. Everybody's a hypocrite to one level or another. Even I, the great one, comes and can't justify all our beliefs. But yeah, it's pretty glaring on Amazon. I think the election is today, and that may be the start of a giant unionization campaign for workers at Amazon. But man, you know, you don't know whether it's true. I've never worked at an Amazon fulfillment center. I see the guys running around delivering stuff, but who knows what the truth is. But you hear a lot, so who knows. But what I can say is it is, you got to have to dislocate a lot of arms to go into the pretzel mode of one election being you need a total proof that you are allowed to vote compared to another election where there any kind of proof would be ridiculous. But that's one of 100 things. Maybe I just don't take it that personally since I read Catch 22. I think it was 13 or 14. And just know that, yeah, everybody's bat crap crazy. And as long as it goes their way, most people are not really going to go and think that hard about anything. But that's it. Okay. Now, another question out here is in GLD. The question is about confluence levels. Well, confluence levels are not what you think they are. I think if you're looking for that in the gold market, in the GLD, really what you have is what you want are very thin levels. In fact, let's zoom in on this so you can see. The thought was from Gary that we're at some kind of confluence level. Well, that goes from 158 to 165. That's $7. So let's call that 5%. Generally, all that does is act as something to slow you down. Just look at that as kind of a old road, unpaved, that now has some ruts in it. And the more it rains, the more it's gooey and hard for the trucks and tanks to get through, a la World War II. Huge walls that are almost impenetrable are very narrow price ranges in the confluence. But if you're watching at this at home, Gary, this is what you want to look at. Confluence levels are two different Fibonacci levels, the 618 of one to the 382 of the other. And if they're very narrow, and by narrow I mean 1%, 1.5%, those tend to be very, very severe resistance and support levels. And that's what you would want to see. This one from that goes from 171 to 173, that's about 1.5%. I actually like them even half that, even more. And of course, a lot of people try to use them on intraday. I've never found them to work that well. They work very well over time. And to give you an idea, you're really talking about a low on March 8th being the common denominator for the first Fibonacci retracement. That's the January 5th level. And then the next one is the August 6th. And of course, when you go back, you're going to find those levels that are going to act as support. But when they're big and wide like that, all they do is tend to slow down the market. I'm not a big fan of trying to short gold here. Could it go a little lower? It could. My thought is that, you got into the 157 area. Could you have a low? Yes. More, I wouldn't use confluence levels here. I would more be thinking about resistance levels if you go long. You know, right now you do have a fairly decent low on lighter volume. The 157.13 low of March 8th had 12 million shares. You're into that with less than six, so not a bad looking thing. But at that point, you're just testing a previous low on lighter volume. So now you probably have some kind of low. But if you're looking for a run back up to 194 without any kind of problem, it's not. You're probably going to get very severe resistance levels at that 171 to 173 level. Okay. Jimmy in the den is down the line of when you come to a fork in the road, take it. That's pretty close, I think, what we're talking about. Another question here for Tesla. They double charged some people, TSLA. I didn't spend a lot of time in it. Here is a good example of confluence levels and when you got into it. Now this one, let's go down here a little bit farther. There we go. And let's zoom into that. Over time, this is a really nice long-term Fibonacci level, and you've got two of them. This is a good one to take a snapshot with. The lower end of that is $547.82 to $569, excuse me. And that's fairly narrow on a percentage basis of the prices we're talking about. Got to $539.49. That was that one day kind of pop. You kind of had a recovery, and then you're right back into it. Now you're back on that level. As I said, I think the easy money in Tesla is over. They are reshorting this stock. I would stay away from it. There are a lot of other stocks that haven't come off the top yet. Those are going to be the ones that you're looking at shorting. And on this one, you're really going to need the market to go higher to turn this around. So not a fan. We'll be back in.
Are you in the market for buying or selling real estate in the Bay Area, including the surrounding St. Petersburg, Tampa, and Clearwater markets? Tiger Real Estate LLC is a firm that has extensive experience in the Tampa Bay Area. Whether you're looking to sell your current property for maximum value, or you're in the market for a second home or investment property, Tiger Realty has the experience across all areas of real estate in the Tampa Bay area to help buyers and sellers make the most informed decisions across all price levels. From the price you should be paying per square foot in certain up-and-coming areas to the type of cash flow investment properties are capable of creating, Tiger Real Estate can help you make the best decision when it comes to all areas of the market. Before you make one of the biggest decisions of your financial future, call Tiger Real Estate LLC today at 727-329-8322 or email us at tiger@tfnn.com. That's 727-329-8322. Call us today.
The technology around us is changing every day. With so much happening, it can seem impossible to keep up with all the information. David White's investment newsletter, The Technology Insider, is designed to give you all the information you need to understand the technology that shapes today's markets and tomorrow's future. David White has made his living staying on the cutting edge of technology. His weekly newsletter will give you specific recommendations for value tech stocks, as well as entry prices, target prices, and stops to set for each trade. Dave delivers his weekly newsletters every Friday with updates throughout the week. You can get the Technology Insider at TFNN.com for only $37.50. Sign up for David's newsletter, The Technology Insider, and get an inside look at everything the technology sector has to offer. Try it risk-free today with our 30-day money-back guarantee. TFNN, educating investors.
Are China A-shares hot or not? If you trade China A-shares, now may be time to take a closer look. Trade CHAU or CHAD, Direction's daily CSI 300 China A-share bull and bear ETFs. China A-shares in either direction. Visit directioninvestments.com today. An investor should consider the investment objectives, risks, charges, and expenses of the Direction shares carefully before investing. The prospectus and summary prospectus contain this and other information about Direction shares. To obtain a prospectus or summary prospectus, please contact Direction shares at 866-476-7523. The prospectus or summary prospectus should be read carefully before investing. An investment in the funds is subject to risk, including the possible loss of principal. The funds are designed to be utilized only by sophisticated investors such as traders and active investors. Distributor Foreside Fund Services, LLC.
Don't forget, you can listen to TFNN live on your mobile device 24 hours per day. Go to TFNN.com, then hit Watch Tiger TV. That's TFNN.com, then hit Watch Tiger TV for the latest market information.
And as we come back, and we've got plenty of time here, I wanted to get to those highly short stocks. As I said, really, when you get into this part of the week, you want to start seeing highly shorted stocks start to squeeze. And for the highly short ones, kind of the worst of the bunch today is Wayfair. You know, volume's going to be okay. It's not going to be that nutty. You got back into a 9 million share high, though, with 1.56 million shares. You had a lot of volume come up. It ran out fairly quick. You had a good short squeeze back here on the first. It's still highly shorted. You just really can't get anything going on it right now, though. And eventually, I think these stocks that really did exceedingly well will give it all up for the shutdown. And of course, if you're in the free state of Florida, that shutdown probably not going to happen. We've got more laws going in here that basically indemnify businesses on those issues being signed today. And Florida kind of leading the nation out of the great abyss. What else do we have here? Okay. Woof, W-O-O-F. Again, not a lot happening on that. Now, on the positive side, you'd think that these things would really be running. The best of the highly shorted stocks today is Gannett. And really, when you look at the chart, not much going on in that. CLNY. Kind of a bounce, but again, not a lot of volume in anything, whether it's up or down. Continues to make me think that maybe we'll have a short squeeze or maybe even a slight squeeze. Maybe we're up another percent as we go into the close on Friday. But I just don't see anything yet. Now, maybe I'll change my mind by the end of the day, but you already got fund buying going. You got 2 days left. Shouldn't you see a lot more? I think you should. Like I said, I'm not ready to pull the trigger short on the market yet, although this thing's not doing much and the volume's fairly light and has been lighter every day since Friday. My guess is we'll go even into lighter volume. That will probably put us up a half percent or a percent into Thursday's close. Maybe you get some stragglers, buy some stuff Monday morning, but I think that's the end of fun buying at that point. Anyway, Colonial Financial up a little bit, but really not making any big sign out here. WB, another one of the highly shorted stocks on this one. You know, still in the downtrend, even though it's up, volume is pathetic. generally, if I want to see a big short squeeze, like I said, it's going to start already. And these massively shorted stocks are not doing anything quite yet. Other stocks in that did well in the lockdown. Dick's Sports, kind of up, not much in the way of volume. Is this turn off as quickly as some of the other stocks? I don't know. Maybe people have gotten used to doing a lot more outside than inside. Hard to tell. Up today. Again, not much volume downstairs yesterday, not much on the way. But if I was looking for some stock to go above its previous high and possibly start a short squeeze, probably the best one out here in that it's close to the highs. It gets up kind of close to there, and the shorts get out of their short positions. That may be one between now and Thursday's close. Okay. Anything else? SABR, another one highly shorted, up 3% on the day. But again, I don't think it really, in the scheme of things on a daily chart, not much happening other than pretty significantly low volume. Let's take a look at Q's real quick and see if we see much in that. Closed out the day yesterday with, let's call it 55 million shares today. You get about 32 million shares being a little lower. Of course, this is and continues to be the weakest market, at least from the advanced decline line. Again, can we just do nothing or slightly higher into Thursday? Probably the most likely scenario without some big news. Okay. See if we have any other questions out here today. Okay. Question about IBM from Johnny. He says that I saw the spot today on CNBC and on quantum computing. We talked a couple weeks ago about another company in this spot. The real problem with IBM's version of quantum computing is noise. And when you're talking about moving electrons around and basically getting those to pair up, which is the whole secret of quantum computers. That is, you can encapsulate two different types of what would you call them? Parts of an atom, electrons, atoms. But because you have to have these things almost at near absolute zero, it is problematic. They've continued to have problems making sensors that can actually tell what state these are in. The other company we talked about from Canada is Photonics, and it doesn't have to be at near zero. Can be moved around a lot more. It doesn't have to have a cryo system with liquid nitrogen running through it. And because it's the way that they've developed this can actually be a expanded incredibly easily like a network where you really have to tie the different qubits together in their quantum states that operate at near zero degree Kelvin. I think at the, what are they, at 1 or 2 degree Kelvin or something? It's like -200 or -300 or -400 or something. Something ridiculous. And, of course, just a big headache compared to what is going to happen. Maybe they've got an application that we don't know about that works better on than the photonic version. But as far as I can find out, no one thinks it's any better or worse. This is a big market, and machines are going to be built for specific tasks. To this point, there isn't enough software out there that makes these computers general purpose quantum computing. So it's going to be a combination of hardware and software. These things run. I just think the Canadian company has a much better shot than the machine that's going to need mountains of support. Time, but again, not even in the first inning. We'll be back then.
Sharpening your skills as an investor is like getting better at playing a musical instrument. You have to practice, sure, but you also need excellent instruction from experts. At TFNN, you'll get advice and guidance from the authority in technical market analysis. And it's not just dry, tedious text either. TFNN airs live financial content streamed live on TFNN.com and TFNN's YouTube channel with Tiger TV, live every market day from 8:30 a.m. to 4 p.m. Eastern. For free. Each host is an experienced trader and gives their take on the market while taking calls and questions live from around the world. From the moment the market opens until the closing bell sounds, Tiger TV has 8 different shows with expert hosts to help you make the right moves with your money. Watch online at TFNN.com or on TFNN's YouTube channel and become the investor you were born to be. TFNN, educating investors.
Markets can rise and fall like the tides. Subscribe to Basil Chapman's newsletter, The Opening Call, and you too can ride the wave. Basil Chapman is an authority in technical analysis. His Chapman Wave trading system has been helping traders identify trends and capitalize on momentum in the markets since 1984. TFNN invites you to test Basil's proprietary Chapman Wave trading methodology with a monthly subscription to the Opening Call newsletter for only $149. Your subscription to the Opening Call comes with a 30-day money-back guarantee, as well as daily market updates on key indexes, stocks, and commodities. Ride the wave! Sign up for the Opening Call risk-free today.
Introducing Primal Edge.
Today, it's even more important to take a supplement that complements your health. Primal Edge is specifically formulated to boost your immune system and help with weight loss, better sleep, stress reduction, and the need to detox.
Our early ancestors found all their nutritional requirements in the wild environment. But today, our food sources don't contain the vitamins, minerals, and nutrients that we need to stay healthy and strong.
That's why we need Primal Edge Daily Nutrition. It includes a special blend of ionic, soil-based vitamins, minerals, fatty and amino acids in an easy-to-use liquid form.
Primal Edge is powered by highly concentrated humic and fulvic acids, nature's preferred delivery system. They've been called miracle molecules because, like sunlight, air, and water, without them, life cannot exist.
That's right, Ellen. They ensure we receive all the nutrition we need to be healthy and thrive.
We take it every morning.
Primal Edge, just $89, exclusively at TFNN.com.
Catch Tom O'Brien, professional trader and educator, founder of TFNN, also a special guest on CNBC. Tom will bisect and dissect the markets. The Tom O'Brien Show, next on TFNN.
And I got a couple things here. I'll answer those questions that just came in after the after I finish the show here. Got one question that ran in front of you in the den, and that is, what's going on with DocuSign? I have to say, this is one of the best looking charts that I've seen. There haven't been a lot. This begs the question of whether or not we're going to get forced into more shutdowns. I know that there's a lot of political reasons why some would want to do that. Bucking the trend, of course, being in Florida, where we're going to have none of it, begs the question of, you know, over the other 49 states, what happens? You know, you got a good looking chart down here. You had a big low at 185.36, 8.8 million shares. You know, you got into it with a little less than 7 million shares on March 5th. Today, so far, you got about 1.5 million shares. Actually, not a bad looking chart out here. The energy off the last high at 226.30 looked fairly good. And let's see what we've got for short docu quick. You got enough shorts in this. Got close to 20% 3 days ago. You're in the 14, 15% on a monthly. You could have more. You only got 1.4. I would suggest that if we get any kind of movement that's slightly higher, I'm going to look for this thing to close at $200 on Thursday's close. Just a guess, but an educated guess, that could go a little higher. Like I said, I know that there are some pushing for more closures, and this is one of the stocks that did incredibly well. If it fails, but it did, that is a long way down. You really don't get into, you know, support back until 92. So what else can you say? Sell when you can, not when you have to. We will see you here tomorrow. Same bat channel, same bat time.